segment in collaboration with Boston Latino. I'm Gil Matos, and in for Greg Molina, who is down in spring training in Fort Myers, Florida, covering the Red Sox, is Cesar Doza.
Good night, my friend.
How you doing?
I don't look like him, but...
No, you got a lot more hair than he does, and you're taller, too. But anyways, today we're going to talk about the Dominican baseball team. I'm talking about the national team that competes in the World Baseball Classic, or will be competing in the second World Baseball Classic in 2009. Recently, or last week, their general director of the baseball team said that they will not field a team in the 2009 World Baseball Classic if they're not considered one of the host sites for the WBC, the World Baseball Classic. What do you think about that?
This goes back and forward. The Dominican Republic is assuming completely a position because if they have 20% of the market players in the Major League Baseball that they can retaliate against the Major League Association by not giving them the power of being the host of this big event.
Yeah, and they're saying that since they have such a rich tradition in baseball, that they should be considered one of the host sites. But the big problem here isn't whether you have tradition or not. It comes down to the mighty dollar once again. And can Dominican Republic and that country support a tournament of this magnitude?
This is supposed to be a sports segment, but in this particular case, we have to involve the economy factor. The economy factor that Dominican Republic is not prepared in terms of money, in terms of stadiums, they don't have many hotels to put people that's going to come to visit this event, people from Italy, people from anywhere. And we're not talking about the first stage of the game, of the tournament. We're talking about semifinals and the final.
Well, they said they would be open to get any part of the tournament, you know, obviously the first couple rounds, in smaller stadiums the first time around. They had it over in Disney and Orlando. They also had it over in Puerto Rico. But the big difference there, they said, once again, Puerto Rico pays in dollars, so does Orlando, Dominican Republic pesos. I'm not so sure there's going to be many Dominicans willing to pay $60, $70, $80 a ticket to go watch this tournament.
Gil, let's put it this way. Does the Dominican population have the power of acquisition in terms of money, in terms of the income salary that the Dominican population have to afford at $80 or $100 ticket, that which is going to be the price that they're going to cost, or just to buy a cap or a shirt that's going to cost you more than $50 or $70? That's not going to happen.
I'm not paying $50.
You don't pay it here. How are you going to pay in Dominican Republic?
You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. And although this World Baseball Classic is a Major League Baseball initiative, they want to spread the popularity of the game worldwide. But let's be honest, there's a bottom line involved with this, there's advertisers involved with this, and you have to generate that economic power. I don't think the island can.
It's always business. Everything is business, and behind everything, the money have to talk. Pepsi, big companies won't be involved in this event if they're not going to have revenues. So in economic terms, it's not going to happen. There's a short term also to rebuild stadiums, to prepare this country, this population, to get ready for a magnitude event like this.
Well, I was at the Caribbean World Series recently in February, and that was hosted in Santiago, which is the second largest city in Dominican Republic. A nice stadium, Estadio Cibao, probably the nicest in the region. It was just recently renovated. That place is not ready for an event of the World Baseball Classic. It's simply not ready. There were empty seats for a game between Licey Águilas, two teams that when they play in October on a Tuesday night, it is jam-packed. But it was not packed on the left field lines, right field lines, a lot of empty seats. Why? Dominicans were not paying $60 a ticket to go watch those games.
We say it once, and I'm going to repeat it again. I take history, I take facts to put things straight ahead. Venezuela had the opportunity to bring the Braves and the Tampa Bay Devil Rays them for one opening day. The stadium have to be rebuilt for at least 1 year and to increase the capacity. And let me tell you something, they didn't have the revenues. They change it. They change it from Venezuela to another place to have opening days in different places. Now it's going to happen in Japan. It's because Japanese people have the power to go to the games.
Same thing. Mexico and like Puerto Rico being considered the other host sites as well. Why? They have the money and they have the economic power to do so. Well, that's it for this segment of the Sus Deportes Boston Latino collaboration. Cesar, I want to thank you very much. And also I want to remind you that you can check these segments out on YouTube.com, BostonLatino.tv, and also check out our website at SusDeportes.com as well, and read our blogs where you can comment on such topics like this. You wanted to say something?
Yeah, don't get me wrong. I would love to be in the Dominican Republic watching a World Baseball Classic with a bottle of Brugal in front of me and the cousin of nephew, Juan Luis Guerra's nephew. But it's not going to happen.
No.
His niece.
I hope you mean this is my language.
However, it's not going to happen. There's no money. Thank you, Hill. Thank you, guys. Thank you, everybody.
Thanks for watching, everybody. Till next time.